Yeah, yesterday we discussed this one, and I hope that you've done it. And the next one we have seen. First thing is you have to make sure, ensure the package is installed properly or it is recognized by the Python. That is another word also we can say. The package is properly recognized, or that is whether it is recognized by the Python or not, it have imported or not. Okay. So in order to check that, we have to use this query. First, we have to import that. MySQL, it's a package, and we have installing the module that is called as connector. Okay, that is the concept that we have seen in yesterday's class. Okay, just we have a very short recap, but then we will go ahead with the next thing. And the first function we used, the connect function. Yesterday we discussed the connect function is used to connect the or create the or establish the link between the Python and MySQL. That is especially with the database, to be literally we want to speak means. Okay. So connect function, we have passed this argument. These arguments are very necessary. That is host and user, that is your username and password we need to give, and database, which database we need to connect. In SQL, it provide, we may create a number of database, no? So among that, which database it want to connect, That is connect function want to connect with that, okay? So the database name, name of the database that we have given, that we should give, okay? This is the thing using the connect function, okay? Then we have seen we need to create a connector object. Here I'm just last thing we have discussed. MyCon, it is not necessary. We can give whatever. See, in the file handling, we used the file object, no? Have you seen that in file handling chapters? We are using,
yes, sir.
A is a file object, B is, likewise, whatever, it is an identifier, that's all, okay? So what is the need of the file object in file handling, I'm asking? Can you say that? What is the required or what is the needs of the file object? Hello, we completed the chapter. You have written the test.
Share also. The file, sir.
Share the file. No. It is not.
We do make a connection between Python and MySQL with a single object.
Okay, pa, that's, I'm asking, the file object is there, no? I'm not asking about the connector object here. In file handling chapter, we are using file object, no? That what is the required or what is the necessity to have the file object? Or uses of file object, you can take that way also. Why we need required the file object? What is the required or what is the necessity? That is, I will tell one example. That is A equal to open of file name, comma, then mode, that is writing mode means R, reading mode, reading mode means R, writing mode means W, append mode means A, that we have given, no, in file object topic, I'm not asking about MySQL, I'm talking about the file object. So why we need to create the file object? What is the use of the,
to use the function, sir.
Yeah, open function, okay. Open function, there also we used. Okay. So we are giving A, B, or whatever object, whatever identifier we are using. No, what is the required of the file object? File object.
Reference of this.
Very good. We
can reference.
Reference, that means in order to, that is through the file object only we can access. Instead of reference, of course, reference also okay. Access the file if you want to do whatever operations. For example, if you want to read, that is read means retrieve the data from the file. It may be a text file, binary file, or CSV file. We have used the file object, no? So in order to read the file or write into the file or appending, that is we are adding something into the file. So whatever operation we are doing, we need the file object. Why, sir? Why this means through the file object only we can able to access the file. Like a key, okay, in dictionary key concept, through the key only we can open the door. Likewise, through the file object only, we can, if you want to write or if you want to read from the file or whatever operations, we can do with the file object. Here, the same thing, why it is a little bit similar, no? That's what I asked that question. Here, MyCon is a file object, you can see I'm highlighting. MyCon, that is my connection. We can give whatever A, B, C or whatever variable we can give, okay? But here it is called as file object, okay? So through the file object only, the connection will be established or the database can be accessed. Likewise, it's a key for to accessing the database, okay? So that is the thing. Okay. Through the, what is the necessary or what is the use of file object? The file object is used to, as you said, reference the database in this case, I'm saying, or else through the access, in order to access the database, we need the object. Here, it is not file object. We are not dealing with the file. We are connecting with the, that is connect with the SQL. That is MySQL. That's what it is called as connector object. MyCon is a connector object. Have you understand what is connector object? Through the object only, we can able to connect. That's what it is called as connector object. Which one? What we here in this example, we given MyCon. We can give A, B, or whatever identifier. That is whatever variable we can use. Yeah, students, have you understand this? What is the use of connector object or necessary of connector object? Have you understand? Yeah. So that's very important. Yeah. Now we can see, we have seen at last is underscore connect function. What is the use of this function? I'm highlighted one. Is underscore connected.
Whether Python is connected to SQL.
Python is connected to SQL or not.
Super. It is just checking whether the connection is successful or not. It succeeded or not. Okay. Just for our clarity. Okay. It is not required every time we need to rent the file. To want to call the function. It's not. It is option for our case. If we need, we can use. But the connect function is there, no? The previous one. Now I am highlighted. The connect function is mandatory. It is very necessary. Without the connect function, we cannot able to connect. Okay, the connect function, it will just establish the connection and give the reference or give the value to the assigning to the object that is called MyCon. That is the connector object. Okay, that's what. Let me go to the next one. Today we will see the few more things. Okay, and apart from that, we have one cursor object. We have to create a cursor.
Okay.
Yes, please.
We need to give password or pass WD.
It's not password. We have to give pass WD. Yeah, that's what it is.
Okay.
Okay, good. So then, okay, sir, we established the connection, sir. We connected with the database. Everything is okay, sir. If you're asking, means no. We need a file in file object. I'm talking about the fifth chapter. That is file handling. Okay. So there we are using file pointer, no? We use the seek function, CKG functions, everything, no? In order to keep the pointer.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you remember that one in the file?
Yes.
Yeah. Likewise, we need a cursor. For example, very simply, if you want to explain means, just you are opening an MS Word. Definitely, we need a cursor to be blink on the document, isn't it? Then only we can do whatever you are typing or you are deleting or you are inserting an image or whatever it may be. We need a cursor, no? Without cursor, we cannot do any operations. Am I right? Correct? No.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very simple. If you are just WhatsApping, okay, you are just texting in the WhatsApp, you need a cursor. Without cursor, for example, you open the keypad, but the cursor is not there. If you are typing, means sometimes a little bit hang. If you are more doing more process, means then it will be get hang little bit, I'm saying. Okay, the cursor will not come. After a long time only, the cursor will be blink. There is a blinking line, no? So then only we can able to type anything. Okay. Likewise, here, let me come to the point. Here, cursor also very important. Okay. From that, you can easily say whatever, if you want to write your data into the database, that is into the record. If you want to insert a record or that is, if you want to store a value or if you want to retrieve the value from the database, especially from the table, or if you want to do any updation process or if you want to do the deletion or whatever it may be, any operations, it should be done through the cursor only. Correct, no? Have you understand this? What is the importance of cursor? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. For example, I am, you can see, I'm just keeping the cursor. You can see this. This is a blinking line. So if I want to type something, then only I can able to type. Okay, without cursor, for example, I'm removing the cursor by clicking outside. So if I want to type means, cannot able to type. Okay, let me come to this thing. Okay, that is, you can see this second point. Okay, as we fire means we are executing or whenever we are triggering or we are action. Okay, that's the meaning of fire. Okay, so when we fire a query means whenever we are firing a query means from Python to SQL, we are firing. That is, we are sending or we are inserting or it's not inserting. We are just sending the query or we are passing the query. Yeah. That is, we are passing the query to the database. From where? From Python. Here onwards, we are just sending or whatever operation is done by in the Python, and through the Python, we are sending it, isn't it? So that's what, whenever we are firing a query to database, it is executed and results set. Okay, result set means everything will be sent as a set of records. You know, record means, you know, so we need to send through the record. For example, how many fields are there? For each field, we need to mention a value. This is a normal one, no? Whenever we are inserting an data, record into the table, insert into record, table name, values of, likewise, we are typing, no? In SQL. Likewise, here also the same thing. Okay, so that's what we need a cursor. That's the importance of cursor, I'm saying. Have you catch the point? What is the importance of cursor?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Let me go to the next one. Yes, now, sir. We are going to create an important one. We are creating a cursor object or name of the cursor. We can say in name of the cursor or cursor object. Okay. So hereafter, we have to refer the cursor object. Okay. So through the cursor object only, if you want to insert any record, if you want to update any record or delete any record, okay, whatever operation we need to do through the cursor object only. Okay. What is the procedure, sir? You can see cursor name. We have to give whatever name as the rules we have followed for identifier, no? The same rule. Okay. Then equal to connection. That is connection means that is a connection object. What is our connection object we have in the previous example we have seen?
Micron.
What is the use of connection object? Let me ask the question. Just now we discussed, no? The connection object
to access the
user's reference.
No. Another one
person. To access the
database. To access the database. Okay, correct. Okay. So we need to access the database. We are set one object, no? That is called connection object. Okay. The connection object will implicitly call the function, connect function. Then through the connect function, we are passing this. Okay. Then dot cursor object through the connection. Once the connection is established, the cursor function will make the cursor to be ready. Where not in Python, in the MySQL, in the database is there, no? It will on the cursor. On means the sense of I'm saying the cursor will be ready to receive the query or receive the data. Have you understand? Which one? The cursor function will do this work. The cursor function will literally create a cursor on the MySQL. Then it is ready to receive the command or receives the value. Okay, value from the Ranjit, you can unmute your video. Yeah, let you see this. Okay, it will will be ready to receive the values from the Python program. Okay, so whenever we execute the Python program, we are typing the value, then automatically the data will be stored successfully stored in the SQL. Okay, that is in the database, I'm saying. Okay, so further, this is the syntax for the cursor name equal to connection object, that is whatever we given as a connection object dot cursor function. Okay, so in our example, as you see, my cursor is the name which we given. So what is the cursor object name means? It is my cursor. Okay, here also we can give whatever name, A, B, C or whatever thing. Okay, equal to my con is a connection object dot cursor function. This cursor function, connect function, is_connected function, these all the functions are defined in the module called as connector. Okay, connector is a module, MySQL is a package. That's what we installed the first thing. Have you understood? Have you understand, sir? Yeah, this is very important step. That's what I'm asking repeatedly. Please kindly say the things. If you didn't understand means, please ask. Let me see the literally, we will execute the query, then we will see. First theoretical concept we want to understand. What is the syntax? What is the use of the function? What actually it is happening whenever we are typing this query? That thing you want to know, no? So for this thing, okay, let me see there. Okay, sir, we created the cursor object, sorry, connection object, cursor object, everything ready. Now we need to do something. We need to create a table or we need to insert any record into the table, no? So we want to execute. For that, we have to call the execute function. This function is also defined in the same module, connector module, okay? So the execute function will accept the query as a parameter, okay? We should pass the parameter in execute function. What query, what parameters are we need to pass the query? That is, query means select all from EMP. Suppose means from the EMP table, it want to display all the records means, or else insert into a value. That's it. Likewise, we have to send the query. Okay. What does the syntax means? Cursor name dot execute function. Execute of query. Query is a normally how we typed in the, what we used in the MySQL, the same query. Let me see. That's what they given, no? In the single quote or double quote, we need to mention. That is very important. Select all from EMP. What is the use of the query, can you say? Just now we discussed, no? select all from EMB means what?
It represents all the rows from that table.
It is all the records.
Retrieving.
Retrieving.
Yeah, it is retrieving or fetching all the records from the table EMP. EMP employee. Is the table name, no? Yeah, that is employee. Good. Have you understand? Likewise, we are executing the query. Let me see this one program. Okay, you can see this. Same thing. We are importing this and we are giving alias name. Why we need to give the alias name, sir? If you are asking the question. For example, here you can see the second line, my MYS we used, no? So instead of, if you didn't give the alias name, what we have to type means mysql.connector.connect. That's what we have to type. Have you understand? So instead of, we are giving a very short name, that is mys or else abc, whatever thing. Okay. So we, whenever we are giving a variable, it is a little bit want to be, what is the thing? The name should be easily understandable. That's what they are using, mycon. That means my connection. Likewise, my cursor. We are giving the actor name. That's all. Okay. It's not necessary, but it is a semantics error. Semantics means for, not for rules, for identification. That's all. Okay. So this is the way we have to think that. Okay. Let me go to the one program. Okay. Okay. Then, okay. For example, here, let me execute this one. For example, my cursor.execute, select all from EMP. Okay. So then we are printing the my cursor, then same command will be print. Actually, it is another one program is there. I will teach to you. Okay. Let me go to the SQL, then we will type it. Open this one, 1 minute. So first I will open the MySQL. Let me create one database, then we will create one, what is the thing? We already created database, no? JE, I think so. Have you remember?
Yeah, yes, sir, JE.
Yeah. Use JEE, I used. Okay. And we, let me see the tables. Okay. So employee one, employee two. So let me take the EMP one table. Okay. What is the EMP one table? Let me see. Or else let me create a new table. Okay. So what is the command to create a new table? Normally we are creating, not through Python. Let me, I will show that one. Can you say that query?
Create.
Create table. So I'm just giving my table. Okay, my table is example, my table, because that name is not there.
Okay.
Yeah, create table, table name, then okay. Field name, isn't it? So what are the fields name?
Yes,
for example, I'm just giving name, that is varchar. For example, I'm saying varchar of 20. Okay, then comma
20.
Okay, city, that is also varchar. Just for example, I'm just creating. Okay, that is also, I'm just giving 20.
Okay.
So let me created the query, created the table. Then let me insert the data into the thing. Insert into, can you say that?
Values.
Values. The values name, no? For example, I'm just giving Raj and then comma, quotes is not mentioned, no? And then city, no? So CHN, that is also
Chennai.
So I just given this is the first record, and second record, can you say any name?
Bala.
Okay. This time
Bangalore.
Okay, fine. Yeah, can you say one more thing just for our seeing that name? Any name?
Suresh.
City.
Delhi.
Okay. Okay, fine. So likewise, we inserted the, we insert, something wrong. Any quote we missed? Okay, let me see this. Insert into table name, we didn't
miss. Insert table name.
You didn't forget, what is the table name? Okay, my table, no?
My table.
Yeah, insert into table name. See, what's the fun? Okay, now it is okay. Let me see this record. Select all from my table. See, I'm typing, but you people are not at all telling. Okay, so what we inserted the name, city, just for example, we have done this. Okay, so now let me see how to fetch the, it is stored in the database, purely it is in the MySQL. Okay, so how to access the data or retrieve the data or read the data from this database. Database is JE and table is MyTable. Okay, so how to access the data? Let me see one example program. Okay, so before that, we want to know the function. Okay. So let me go to this thing. Now you are familiar about it. Let me go to the next one. There are three type of functions. Three type of functions are there. Okay. In order to access the record or retrieve the record or read the record. Okay. Or fetch the record, whatever word. So from read the fetch the record, fetch means get or get the record from the database. Three functions mainly we are using. You are seeing in the slide. Fetch all. From the name itself, you can understand. Fetch all the record. If you want to, sir, whatever in the table, sir. For example, a table contains 50 records. I want to retrieve all. I want to see all the records. All the 50 records means fetch all function. That's all. Okay. Fetch one. Fetch one means first record alone. Okay. That is first record. Second time, if you are executing the fetch one function, it will retrieve the second record. Okay. Only one record only I want, sir. If you are asking, means let me use the fetch one function. Select second one part. Okay. Fetch one function is used to retrieve. That is here, the function will return. That's what they given. Okay. The fetch all function return all the records in the form of tuple. Let me go to the first one. You can see this. It is returning. That is fetch all function return all the records. Return all the records means retrieved and return to the wherever the call statement is made. Of course, it is a function, no? So we need to make a call statement. So that in the call statement, some variable is ready to receive the value, no? So that variable will receive that to that it will return. Okay. So return all the records in the form of tuple. That is very important. How it will return, sir? It is in the form of tuple. That is very important. Okay. Let you see the next one, fetch one function. It return only one record. That is only one record from the result set. Result set means records. Result set means a row means it contains what? N number of fields, no? For our case, how many fields? That is how many columns in our table? Two columns we created.
Two columns.
Name and the city. Likewise, we can create a number of columns, no? That you already know. That is called as the result set. Okay. That is first time it will return the first record. Next time, if you are executing the same query, means second record and third. Likewise, if you are using the fetch one, likewise, if you are using means, it will record one by one. It will access one by one. So whenever the cursor, whenever the pointer or cursor is close to the last one, if no more record, for example, 10 records are there, all the 10 are fetched. Whenever it's returned the last one, it will return none. That is very important. The fetch one function return none when no more records in the table. Do we understand fetch one function? Hello? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
The next one, fetch many. So from the name itself, again, you can understand. From many means we can access n number of records, as I said. So for example, let you take, for example, your table contains 50 records, 50. Okay. Suppose I need first 5 records, sir. If you need, ask means. You can say, fetch many of 5. Fetch many. N is there, no? N means here we have to pass the number as argument. It should be integer. Okay. So fetch many of 5, if you mention, means what will happen? 5 records. That is, first 5 records will be retrieved from the, that is, database, especially from the table. Okay. Likewise, it will return. Next time, you have used the file concept, same thing, read of 5 means first 5 character, read of 10 means first 10 character, that we have seen, no, in file handling chapter. Have you remember that, bro?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, likewise, it is somewhat close to the file handling. That's what first we have discussed, the file handling. Let me come to this. But what is the thing here? More facility are there. Let me see it. Okay. So likewise, N means record, that much record. For example, 3 if you mention means first 3 record will return. Okay. Second time, if you are using the function, whenever we are calling the function, fetch many of, next time also 3 means first time 1, 2, 3 record, then 4, 5, 6. Then third time, if you are executing the 3 means 7, 8, 9, likewise. Have you understand? So whenever it goes to the last, no record, no more records is there, means it will return empty tuple. Empty tuple is returned. That is parenthesis, empty parenthesis. That is empty tuple. So this is the main difference. Fetch one, can you say, can anyone can say that what is the difference between fetch one function, fetch many function from the slide? Yeah. Hello. Can you able to say the difference? difference between fetch one function and fetch many function?
Fetch one function will return one record every first time and next record second time continuously.
Good, good.
Fetch many
yes.
Fetch many will return total number of records mentioned. If no more record is if the amount mentioned is more than the record present, it will return an empty tuple.
It is not like that. I can very good, nicely said. But one more clarification I want to give. For example, totally in our case, we inserted four records, no? Sorry, three records, no? Raj and some other two names, isn't it? So three records we inserted. Suppose fetch many of five, if I give means, it won't show any error. But instead of five, totally three records only there. So it only returned the three records. Okay. For example, first three records, fetch many of three I given. Okay. So three records is returned. Correct, no? Second time I'm executing the same query, fetch many of three. Then that time what will happen? Already totally three records only there. First three are already accessed. That is, it is already returned. Next time the cursor will be at last point. No more record. No, that time it will return what? As
empty tuple.
Okay. Fetch one. Whenever empty tuple. What it will return? Whenever no more records is there means?
None.
That is the main difference. Fetch one will return none when no more records are there in the table. Fetch many will return empty tuple when no more records are there in the table. That's all. Okay. So I hope you all understand that fetch all, fetch one, fetch many. This is the very prominent, very important functions. Whenever we have to access anything from the database, without the three function, we cannot access. That's what, that is a very important one I'm saying. Okay. So this concept is very important. Let you go to the last one, row count. It is a special keyword likewise. Okay. So it's not a function, but this keyword will tell number of records so far accessed from the table or from the database or from the SQL. Okay. It will count automatically. It will count automatically whenever we are using the word. Okay. So that's what you can see the definition. It will return number of rows retrieved, accessed, fetch, get, or read. Okay. Whatever word. Okay. So retrieved from the cursor. From the cursor means it will just taking over the cursor. The cursor is retrieved one record because through the cursor only we can access. No, that is cursor means cursor object I am saying. Okay. Cursor object or cursor name. Okay. So for how many access, for example, a table contain likewise the 50 records are there. Okay. The row count function, the row count keyword will keep it in its memory. It will store in its memory means how many records will be retrieved from the cursor. Okay. So through the cursor, how many records so far accessed? So that it will check. Okay. That is the use of the row count function. Have you understand this one? Have you understood this one? Hello? Hello, can you able to hear? Yeah, that is, it was disconnected. I will repeat the point which I have thought, I think you may lost that row count function, a row count keyword I'm saying. The row count is used to, I'm selecting the last one. Okay. It will note down that how many records so far accessed through the cursor. Okay. From the table. Okay. So it will return number of rows. Rows means number of records. Okay. So number of records or number of rows retrieved from the database, or from the table through the cursor so far. So that it will roll, that it will count itself. It will count whenever we are just using the word. That's all. Okay. We have to mention the cursor object dot row count. If you simply mention means, if you want to assign to a variable, okay, then it will automatically, this function, I mean, this word will, the special word will return to the, that will return the value to the variable which we are using. Okay. So that is the use of row count. Okay. It will tell how many records. Row means record, no? So how many records or how many rows are accessed, retrieved from the database. That is the thing. I hope you all understand the fetch all function, fetch one and fetch many, isn't it? And row count also too. Theoretically, yes, and users, have you okay? Are you all okay? Then we will go with the practical one. I mean, literally, we will see the code. Shall we go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes, good. Let me write the command. 1 minute. I will just open the Python. 1 minute. Okay, we'll just open a new file. Okay, first thing, what we need to import, we need to import the package, no? MySQL package. So first line, we have to type import. Yeah, you have to report, just tell with me. What are the thing? This you have to tell, then I will type it simply. Import, what is the package? MySQL connector. Connector is a module. Okay, MySQL.connector. So that we import. If you want to give an alias name, we can give it. Okay, or else we can leave. Okay, so first without alias name, I'm just teaching. Okay, next thing, what we need to do? We need to create a connection object. Am I right? So just I'm just giving MyCon, or else whatever object we can give. Okay, my connection, that is MyCon. Here we need to use the function. Which function is used to connect? That's what we have seen in theoretical, no? Which function is used to establish connect function? So
connect function.
Connect. Okay. Sorry.
MySQL dot connect.
MySQL.connector.connector.
Ah, very good. Very good. So where the connection function is just.
Can you give alias name, sir?
Yeah. Yes.
You give alias name for MySQL.
Yeah. Alias name also we can give. For example, I'm just typing. In order, you all people want to understand. No, that's what MySQL is a package and connector is a module. Okay, connector is a module. There we are using the function connect. Connect is a function. So what are the things we have
host to? Host is equal to localhost.
Host. So first one is host equal to. We need to give a localhost is an our normal thing. We didn't use any server, so that's what we have to use localhost. Okay, fine. First thing is okay. Next is what?
Pass user.
Yeah, correct. No, user equal to, we need to give our username. So my username is root. I have fixed. It is the default name. I just given like that. And next one is password. Okay, password. That is the thing. I can only able to see
yeah, what I'm
typing. Yeah, 1 minute. I will minimize the screen because yeah, only one W. Just watch.
Sir.
Yes.
Can you give password as password, whether it will work?
No, we should use like that only. Let me try it. As you ask, I will try it. First, we will execute this one. Okay. Okay, Harit. So password equal to, we just given, my password is 12345. That's why I just given. Then database name. Okay. What is our database we created? JEE, isn't it? So that we have.
JEE.
Yeah. This is the thing. Now we successfully created the connector object. Our connector object is MyCon. Now we need to create the second object, that is called cursor object. Okay. So I'm just giving my cursor or CR, my CR cursor. Okay. So I'm just giving whatever we can give. Okay. So if you want to create a cursor, so for which purpose we are creating the cursor? In order to access the database. How we can access the database? Through the connect object only, no? There is connector object only. What is the connector object? MyCon. MyCon.cursor function we need to call. Okay. Cursor. So we are calling the cursor function. Now successfully we created our cursor function also. That is cursor name also, or else a cursor object also. Now we need to execute the query. Okay. So let me access this. First we need to execute, no? So how to access means, how to execute means, hereafter we have to use only what? The cursor object.
Okay.
So my CR is a cursor object. Okay. Dot execute. Sorry, 1 minute. Okay. Execute. Suppose we need to store into a variable. No, that's what. 1 minute. I'm just giving data equal to my CR. It's a cursor object. Dot execute of what is the thing? We need to execute that thing. No, what is the query we have to give? So sorry, 1 minute. First we need to execute, then only we can store. Yeah. So say if, suppose I want to retrieve all the records from the table which we create, my table, no? So how to, what is the query to access all the records? It's not access. If you want not, what is the general?
Select star from.
Very good, very good. Select all from my table. That is our table name. So that is the query we have used. I just completed one. Okay. Now we need to fetch the record. Okay. So this query will access all the things. Now we need to take from the SQL to here, no, from the Python to the Python, no. So here I'm just giving a variable data equal to one variable or whatever variable you can give. Okay, then what is the thing? What is the cursor name? Sorry, cursor object. My no, that is connection object, man. This cursor object is my CR only, no. So my CR dot. So I want to fetch all the records, means fetch all. Okay, so I have to give. Now all the record will be fetched from the database, and it will be stored in the form of tuple. Where it will be get stored? The variable called as what? Tuple. Okay. So I'm just printing the data. Data is object will receives all the things. No. So I'm just saving this file. Just a minute. 1 minute. I'm just storing in the desktop itself. Giving. Okay, JEE1, okay, .py. That is say, I'm just giving, it's stored in the desktop. Okay, now I will just run this program. Let me see what are the errors. If any error is there, means it will return. See, it successfully retrieved, no? Raj, Chennai, Bala, Bangalore, Suresh, Delhi. Have you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How it will retrieve? How it will retrieve in the form of? Correct, no? So yes. That's what we need. Okay, so that is the answer. See, Raj Chennai is one tuple. Bala Bangalore, which we given, that is another tuple. And Suresh Delhi, that is a third element. Okay. Likewise, it will return in the form of tuple. Okay. This is the use of fetch all. Suppose, sir, I need only one record, sir. Let me use this one. I will just closing this function. So fetch. What is the only one record means? What is the function?
Fetch one.
Fetch one. So here I am just giving the fetch one function. Same thing. I'm saving the file. I'm running it. So what will be the output? First record only it will show. Have you understood? So first record only. Second, suppose you can see second time if you use this means it will return what? Second record alone it will display. Third time if you execute means third record alone it will display. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, and you can see 1 minute file will close this one. Okay, now fetch many. Okay, we have to mention the number. Fetch many of, we need to mention the number. Suppose I'm giving two. Okay, forever we have only three records, no? That's what. Suppose I will use the row count. I didn't use, no? You can see. I'm giving a variable row count, RC equal to, what is the cursor object? What is the cursor object?
My
cursor object dot. What is the keyword which used to retrieve the row count? I mean, to count the row. Row?
Row count.
Okay, that's all. Okay, that will be stored in RC. I'm just printing the RC. Okay, that is a normal print statement. Records retrieved so far, or else the total number of records retrieved, whatever type we can type, total number of records retrieved. Okay, so we just given I'm just giving you a colon, that's all. And where we then which is the variable stores the value, RC, isn't RC. It so that we have stored. Okay, so just we print this, we are asking to access the fetch many two records we are asking. Let I will save this file. I'm executing this, you can see. So two records has printed. See total number of record retrieved so far, two. Okay, then first record and second record. Have you understood? Yes, have you understood all those things?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good, good, very good. So I hope you understand that how to access, that is how to retrieve the data from the from the SQL, from the database. Okay, so we didn't open this one. I'm not using anything. Okay, you are seeing that. Okay, it is not required to be open. I'm just closing it also, it will work. Okay, I'm just close this one, even though it will work, not an issue. Have you understood? So it is not necessary to be the record to be, I mean the database to be opened, or we need to open so far. Just opening purpose, I just done it. Okay, I hope you understand how to use the fetch all, fetch many, and one more thing is what? Fetch one. Okay, so how to access this record? That's what. Suppose I'm giving five, as we discussed. No, so far how many records are there in our table? My table, three records.
Three.
Suppose I'm just giving fetch all five. I'm just giving. Okay, so let me see what will be the output. See, number of records retrieved, three. Three records only it will retrieve. Even though we ask you to retrieve five, but what is the thing? There is no five records. So only three records are there. That's what it is retrieving, first three, then fourth record is there, no, it's not there, and fifth record also not there. So that's what is returning only what? The three records. Have you all understand that, how to use the fetch functions, all the functions?
Yes, sir.
Fine.
Yes, sir.
So go ahead with the slide. People, you have any doubt, pa? If you have any doubt regarding this, please ask. Or anything means clarification or anything. Do you have anything? I mean, having
no,
anything? Okay. So you, whenever you are trying, you just try this one. This is your task today. Just try this one, and you have to give your username. That's maybe it may be root. Suppose you, if you change it, means you have to give that name. And password is your password which you have given. And database also same thing. What is the database which already created in your MySQL? No. So that's after what database we are using, that we have to give. In our, in my computer, J is there. That's what I given my password and my database. Okay, that's name. Okay, and the table also same thing. Okay, sir, I want to create a table, sir. So let me write a query for create a table. We access that. We are used that. Select all from the table. Now, sir, I want to create a table. So can you say the what is the query? What is the query?
Create table name.
Man. Yeah, create table. Same thing only. Okay, then. So let me give my table one we already created. No, let me give my table one.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so my table one, then record, for example serial number I'm just giving, that is integer. Okay, then can you say anyone? Employee name.
Name.
Yeah.
Name.
That is where care. Okay. Yeah, 20. Okay,
then department.
Department, DEPT, that is also what? Can you say anything? That is where care, no?
Yes, sir, where care.
Care, I'm just giving 10. Okay.
10.
If you want to add anything, serial number.
City.
Number. City, okay, good. City, I'm just adding, that is where care. Where care, I'm just giving 20 again. Okay, that is the thing. Create table, table name, that's we created, okay. So now we successfully created this one. Now we need to insert the record. Suppose, let me see, that we will see later, because before that you want to learn some concept. Okay, so I'm just closing this one. I'm removing all those things. Okay, so execute, this query I have executed. Okay, let you see. I'm saving this file. I'm just using the adding a print statement. Okay, successfully, table text successfully created. Okay. Table has successfully. This time typing. Okay. Creator. Just for our confirmation. That's all. Okay. Nothing yet. You're just giving a print statement. So I'm just executing then. Oh, it's showing error. What's the error? J1.py. Okay. Let me see what are the error we have made. 1 minute. Create table, table name, okay. Then what is the thing? Records we just given. What are the fields we given? That is serial number, integer, e name, that is employee name, where care. What is the error? Can identify. I think everything is correct. Let me see that. J is a database. Okay, fine. I think we close the bracket also properly, isn't it? That's the problem, I think so. We didn't close it properly, no? Yes. Have you noticed? Yeah. Yeah. First execute function we open, at last execute function we close it. Okay. And you can see my table we opened on bracket, no? That we didn't close it. Now only we closed. I thought of we closed only the 20. So let me execute this one. So you can see this. Yeah, table has successfully created. Let you open the database and verify the table is literally this created or not. Okay. 1 minute. I will show that one. So I'm just opening the MySQL. Now JE, no? Use JE. Then show tables. Now you can see my table one is created, isn't it? Can you able to see this, my table one? I'm just about to describe my table one in order to see that. Okay, my table one. You can check serial number, employee name, department, city. How we described there in the Python, it is exactly, it is comes in there, it is stores in the, properly stores in the MySQL also. I will understand now how to create a table, first thing. So how to create, you know, already how the data, suppose the data is already, the record is already stored in the database. For example, in your project, that will be very important. You may easily create a record by in SQL. How to retrieve the record, sir, or how to fetch the record from the SQL, sir, in Python. That we have seen. Have you all understand this one? Have you all understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. Do you have any doubt regarding this? I will show the program also one more time. See, this is the simple thing. What we have used, the same query here also, the same thing, nothing, that the bracket, quotes that we have to concentrate, that's all. Okay, so that's all, nothing yet. Have you all understand this? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Very good, very good. Do you have any doubt, means let you please ask, isn't it? Do you have any doubt or clarification is needed for creating a table, accessing a table through the Python? Is it okay? First, yes or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, tomorrow let me see how to insert the record. So far we know how to create the table, how to retrieve the data. Suppose I want to insert the data into the table, sir. We will see it. Okay, tomorrow's things, we will discuss all those things. And I hope this week we will plan, we will try. It's not necessary to complete this very stipulated time. That is very important. But your understanding is very important. Okay. Let me see the tomorrow things and all. We will see the example that we have done already. These three examples. Okay. Fetch one, fetch many. Okay. This is the output. Let me see this tomorrow. And let me go to the another concept. How to write into the data. That is insert into the data. That we will see in the tomorrow's case. Okay, students. And take this screenshot. Just can you WhatsApp me what will be the output? Just you can take this snap of that whenever you are working in the computer. Now you can take this screenshot of this one and execute in your computer. You can give your own database name. There's everything you can change. Okay, what is the output of the program? This type of questions will be asked. Take a screenshot in your mobile phone. Later you can try in your computer and you can just send to me the WhatsApp whether you have what output you got. Have you taken? Are you taken this?
Yes,
sir. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, students, very nice time with you. Let me discuss tomorrow also and the rest of the topics. Thank you to all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.